Episode 2. If this is your first visit to this series, make sure you watch the intro video and learn how this series is structured and to help you get the best out of these videos. This episode will pick up where episode 1 left off. Our opponent won the opening roll with 1-6, making their 7 point. We followed up with the roll 3-4, and we chose to split and down. And we learned just how much better this split is compared to this split. So we played 21-9, and then our opponent rolled 5-1. Their play was 8-23, fairly obvious. And then in episode 1, we rolled 1-4, giving us the interesting choice between making the 20 point or making our 5 point. Now, in this episode, instead of 1-4, we're going to look at the roll 1-2. What would your play be at each of the three match scores in this position with a roll of 1-2? Pause the video. So in this position, 9-away, 9-away, the first of our match scores, 1-2 is best played, 7 point or 21 point, the two obvious plays. It is the 21 point. And interestingly, it's clear. Making the 7 point in this position is halfway to blunder. How many of you chose to make the 7 point in this position? Our next match score, 4-away, 2-away, very aggressive match score with our emphasis being on our home board. 7 point or 21 point? The best play is the 21 point. Now making the 7 point here makes a lot of sense. We're making a point, creating 3 points in a row. Our emphasis, our play is down here by our home board, yet still making the 21 point is the best play. I'll talk more about this after we finish this and we look at our third match score. Our last match score for this position, roll 2-1, 2-away, 4-away. Match score where our emphasis is on making an anchor in our opponent's home board. And here we have the opportunity to make the 21 point. It's clear. This is an easy one. We make the 21 point. Making the 7 point in this position at this match score is a double blunder. And if you catch yourself making a move like this when the match score is 2-way, 4-way, or something close to this, you really have to reevaluate what your priorities are, what your game plan is. When you evaluate the board, but you also take into account match score. Now I said I would talk a little bit more about this. When we have a position like this, I don't want you to think of this as I get to make a point. I don't even want you to say, I can make the 21 point, I can make an anchor. We have to look at what it actually is. Of the anchors we can make, these are our two best anchors. So I want you to say to yourself, this roll gives me the opportunity to make the second best anchor that I can make. I want you to think of it as the second best anchor, not just a point, not just an anchor. And that's why in all three of our match scores, the best play was making 21 point, our second best anchor. Now for our second decision in this video, instead of moving forward one play, we're just gonna alter our opponent's position. We're gonna take a checker off the 8 point and put it back at the 13 point. So we're changing the position in our favor, we're weakening our opponent's position, and we're stripping our opponent's 8 point. We're taking our opponent's position from 10 checkers down here down to 8. How much did this change things? What would you do now with a roll of 1-2 in this position at our three different match scores? Pause the video. Now in this position, our opponent's attack, if they were to attack us, is not as strong, because of the stripped A point, 9 checkers versus 10 from our first position, the best move, they're actually tied. The best move is making the 21 point. You can make the 7 point in this position, but they're perfectly tied. Now, that's at 9 away, 9 away. What about 4 away, 2 away? Now, 4 away, 2 away, where our emphasis is this part of the board, building a home board point, blocking these anchors, attacking. Now the 7 point should be clear because our opponent's home board isn't as strong. And yes, the 7 point is the best move, but only by 5. 0-0-5. It is as close to tie as you can get. You can still make the 21 point in this position, even with the weakening of our opponent's position. And for this position, our final match score, 2 away, 4 away, our emphasis should be over here. This is obvious. We still make the 21 point without hesitation. But remember, it's not the 21 point, it is our second best anchor. And one thing we do have to remember in a position like this is that we're sort of threatening, if you want to use the word threatening, we're threatening to make our second best anchor. With most rolls, this checker is going to get hit. So when we're given the opportunity to make this anchor before this checker gets attacked, we need to make it. Let's do a quick review of what we've just seen. So here are our 6 decisions we had to make. In our first position, this position, the 21 point is our cash game play. It's our play when the match is tied, when there's a long way to go. At 4 away, 2 away, we still make the 21 point. And the 7 point's playable. It's within the error range. It's not best, but it's within the error range. And then at 2 away, 4 away, easily. We're looking at a anchor here, an advanced anchor, double blunder to make the 7 point in this position. Now, position 2, this position, we still make the 21 point. At 4 away, 2 away, we can still make the 21 point. And at 2 away, 4 away, again, that should be the obvious play. What's interesting is we have 6 different decisions we looked at. You can make the 7 point in 3 of these. 2 of these, they're within the error range. From my point of view, we're not machines. We're not the world's best backgammon player. These are tie. So making the 7 point is tie in 3 of our 6. But in none of the 6 choices that we had was making the 7 point ever clear. It's either tie or it's a big mistake. So what that can tell you, and it can vary from position to position, but what that can tell you is, how much are you valuing your advanced anchor? Are you overvaluing making the 7 point? And a lot of new players, including myself when I first started playing this, this looks visually so good. We go to 3 in a row, we're blocking these checkers down here, but many players overvalue the making of the 7 point when there's something else important to be done on the board. And that'll end episode 2.